Hello everyone, I'm Gabor Kelemen, still working for Hungarian National Infocommunication Services Corporation, still on the Hungarian Ministry's migration to LibreOffice, and I would like to talk about a little bit of interoperability today, because we decided to go with OOXML as tool of interoperability, and there is another source of problems that we have not tried to tackle as a project yet. So, if we try to edit existing OOXML files in LibreOffice or create new ones, we face the fact that LibreOffice is pretty much built around the ODF standard and the feature set defined by the ODF standard. Or it is the other way around, I'm not sure. Still, some folks like us try to edit other formats with LibreOffice. And we are facing during this a lot of filter level interoperability bugs that are with saving and opening features that are already existing in both products and both formats. I'm not going to talk about this. Stay for the next talk. László will talk about this topic, hopefully. And on top of all of this, LibreOffice has some features that are simply not present in Microsoft Office or its OOXML format. And we would like to still do something about this situation. So, we are giving LibreOffice to users, and users are trying to do their best with the tool given. After a little bit of saving and reopening some files, they still find that their formattings or settings are simply gone. And not because we are using some existing features that are present in both software, but because we are using something that is very LibreOffice specific. So it is actually impossible to write those out to OOXML, because that standard doesn't define anything for that situation. So that's the problem. Not a huge problem, so to say. Existing features are a much larger headache, but still. So I would like to propose a solution and some examples later, that when we are trying to edit OOXML, we should a little bit tailor the user interface to the settings of and features of that standard. How? We would like to introduce a new configuration key that system administrators could turn on, and also users could it turn off. In that case, user interface elements would be that are known to be problematic. Those would be simply just hidden and not visible for these users, and they could not simply just shoot themselves in the foot. The good news about this is that there are maybe a few dozen situations like this. I have prepared with three examples. So one is bug 101.3.22. Subtitle in charts is not preserved in XLSX format, because simply that is ODF specific. What can we do about this? I think we should just hide the subtitle box in that dialogue. And boom, no way to shoot yourself in the foot. I actually prepared a demo for this. So hopefully I can show. Not this one. So in LibreOffice 6, you can create chart subtitles like this in ODF. Works very fine until you are not trying to save this into XLSX, which we are trying. So here, I think, can edit and it's really hard to see. Moment, please. Yeah, so it's a Hungarian, but title, subtitle, and it's on the chart. Very good. What about changing LibreOffice to do instead? In 6.3, my current version, like this. No subtitle box, no way to shoot yourself in the foot. Very simple, and I think it should be pretty straightforward to use this approach. So, back to the presentation. Okay, next example. Pie and donut charts appear mirrored when compared to Microsoft Office. So it means that we are by default laying out pie chart slices counterclockwise, and MS Office lays out them clockwise order. And when we try to save this in OOXML, there is no option for this to save. So when people insert a pie chart, save it, reopen it, and they see it's mirrored. What the hell? Did I do something wrong? No, they did not. But still a little bit of source for confusion. But what if we would just change this default rotation setting, and people would see the same as with OOXML format. Okay, next one. There is no bug about this, but I think we could reduce a little bit of confusion here. So in thoughts, we have cell validation as feature, and it has a list type. We can just enter items in a list in the dialog window, and they appear as validation options. Well, Excel doesn't have this feature, not at all. This type of list doesn't exist there. And we can export this to XLSX, but with some limitations on the length. But what's worse, Excel calls something list as well, but the list they call is what we call cell range. So user confusion is absolutely guaranteed, because same thing has different names. But what would happen if you would just hide the list type that has different meaning and a different behavior as well. Maybe even we could rename this cell range, depending on this configuration key, to list. So users with a mixed office environment, they would be less confused. Okay, less. What's my long-term goal with this? We should try to better fit LibreOffice in mixed office environments. Our goal is not to completely eradicate Microsoft Office from ministry workstations and all kinds of state-run workstations, but to coexist. And I think this would be a way to help that. And also, I think it could help LibreOffice become a free OOXML editor, which we don't want to be yet. But I think that would be our goal, at least in the NIST project, that simply reliably works. So our users' most common complaint is that LibreOffice is unreliable. They do something, doesn't go through, doesn't round trip. So one part of that is because missing features and filter bugs. One way of that could be features that are present in OOXML, present in ODF, but not in OOXML. So this is just about hiding that part of the foot gun. So that would be it. Thanks for your attention. And I would like to ask your opinions about this, because most of this is just idea. Nothing is submitted yet to the code base. So I would like to ask if this makes any sense to you.
Yeah. Isn't it the other way around? What I think that you're trying now is replace ODF for OOXML and leave the ODF path, and a bit like if you can meet and join them. But I still think ODF is the better data source.
Okay, that's your opinion.
So why not try the other thing?
Because they said in the preparation meetings for this project, they said it's either OOXML or no project. That's why.
Oh, okay.
Okay, next, please.
We have a foreign format warning when saving a file. Wouldn't it be useful for the user to list the features which are not supported by OOXML, so that he, instead of hiding it, so that he is informed that ODF can more than in this special case as OOXML?
Yes, that would be possible, I think, to warn people, but then you are wasting their work time, because you're telling them after they spent a day working on a document that, this is not going to work. That's my problem. Exactly. Yes?
And another question. How do you try to solve the table problem? Tables in OOXML are always floating, and tables in ODF not.
Okay, that's a very difficult problem, and we would need to put a lot of development efforts into making LibreOffice better suited for OOXML creation. So far, we have three developers, but we plan to expand our developer base by a lot. So this is sort of a work in progress, and I would like to see that our developers solve this problem, because users are actually suffering from it. Yeah, so that's That's one of those things that we are planning to solve in the next 2 years.
What I think makes sense is changing the default rotation of a pie chart. I'm afraid if you start working in direction of more support for OOXML by default, that you end up somewhere in between that OOXML, it just not works because LibreOffice is different and ODF doesn't work either. So I'm not sure if I'm convinced yet,
configurable for, so much of the user base with ODF would not be affected. Yeah. It would be turned off by default.
Okay.
So we would just improve OOXML, because that's what's expected from us. Cisco?
Yeah, so you saw this dialogue where you fixed the problem by moving the text box, but that's only not displayed XLSX format, right?
Yes.
But then what happens if you open an ODS file, you edit this subtitle thing, and then you save it as XLS file, then you have the same problem.
I'm not sure I can follow, because if there is an existing ODF with this setting, that would be lost when saving to XLSX anyway. So it's just a way to prevent creation of not working features. So that's the goal. And also, already existing ODF files are not very widespread in the user base of ours. So that's another thing. Okay. More questions?
Yes, what do you do about the different versions of OOXML? You have, when you use Microsoft Office, you have the choice between the Microsoft OOXML and the strict OOXML. And when you load a strict OOXML in LibreOffice and save it, it will not be opened correctly.
We have not really faced this problem because most of our user base is on Office 2010, and that is not creating such yet. So that's a problem for the future, I think. Okay, any more questions? Do we have still time? No more questions. Okay, thanks for your attention.